Hey there, everyone. Merry Christmas. Today is the sixth day of Christmas, and we hear this. Do not love the world or the things of the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of God is not in him. And for all that is in the world, sensual lust, enticement of the eyes, and a pretentious life, is not from the Father, but is from the world. Yet the world and its enticements are passing away, but whoever does the will of God remains forever. I know that as Americans, we associate Christmas with gift giving, and I don't want to discourage gift giving. I think that comes from a true place of love. I think a lot of people's love language is gift giving and gift receiving, and so it really means a lot to them to simply give something and have the time of picking it out, and also to receive something knowing that someone spent time doing that. So I am not trying to discourage gift giving in any way, shape, or form. Have we become materialists, though? We become so bound up in the stuff that we have, that we identify our well-being and our life by the stuff that we have, by the house we live in, the cars we might drive, by the gadgets we might have, by the fancy things we might own. You know, are we comparing ourselves with the people next door or across the street or other family members who maybe have more or less? I must be doing better off because I have this thing and they don't, or vice versa. Is it something we struggle with? I think it's an important thing to keep in mind during this great season of gift giving. Am I giving in to that, the enticements of the world? Right? Am I getting stuck on what the world has to offer and wanting more of that? Right? Everything, the scripture is very clear, everything will pass away. The world and its enticements are passing away. Those things at some point won't exist anymore. Your soul and my soul will, though. It exists for all eternity. Do I judge myself or others off of the things they have? During this season of gift giving, have I given a gift to Jesus? What does Jesus really want? He doesn't want toys. He doesn't want gadgets. He doesn't want a new house. He just simply wants your heart and my heart. Have I given a gift to Jesus yet this year? Have I given to him something of myself? It could be pretty powerful. It could help us to not be so caught up in worldly things. Merry Christmas, and God bless you.